Our origin, the culture and tradition we were born out of, is inextricably tied to our greatness. To understand Grand Seiko is to understand Japanese tradition. The honor in being a craftsman, always embracing the past, but looking to the future, of leading a life dedicated to precision, care. Original and creative design, hand finishing and assembly, all meticulously done.
私は中澤大輔です。2013年の8月22日です。ゼロから始めました。19歳の時から寿司の修行を始めました。魚の素材の力を引き出す、それが仕事ですね。お客さんのため、ひいては自分のためなんですけども、そのために今日できるベストのことはいつもするように心がけてます。一番難しいことっていうのは、言葉で伝えられないことなんですね。リズムだとか、リズムとか、あと雰囲気。
The struggle for perfection is something that's essential to help create a better watch. There's nothing frantic, confused, or unintentional about Grand Seiko from start to finish. With Grand Seiko's craftsman, Chef Nakazawa, these are some of the minute details that maybe most customers don't understand or don't see. Everything needs to be perfectly clean, perfectly polished. Everything needs to be organized well in order for you to do an efficient job. If you don't have the right tools, you can't make the quality that's necessary. And this is true in anything in life. You need to have the right tool to do the job properly.
あの包丁は僕がお店を11年目に辞めるときに最後に二郎さんにもらった包丁です。カウンターに入るときには必ず砥石で研ぎます。やっぱりそうですね、切れる包丁で仕事をするのはリズムが良くなりますし、自分でもやってて気持ちがいいと。一応別にその科学ではシャープナイフで切った方が、細胞が壊れないっていうのを見たことがありますけれども、本当に食べ比べて分かる人がどれだけいるのか私には分かりませんと。
Chef Nakazawa's blade is super sharp, right? And it has to be. That's, you know, it's his performance tool. In order to have a sharp blade, you know, you need to essentially polish it. You're almost grinding it to achieve that perfectly sharp edge. Zeratsu is very similar in the sense that you're pushing the case against this flat, broad surface to achieve a perfectly flat mirror surface. But at the same time, you can attain, by polishing two separate edges, just as in a knife, you can bring them into one very fine meeting point, which is that crisp, defined edge that you will find in one of the best examples, 44GS. Razor sharp. Perfect flatness. You need to have a very, very strong skill set with Zeratsu to achieve a perfectly flat surface. You need to have the feel. And that's distinctly important. The few craftsmen, women who are doing the Zeratsu polishing technique for Grand Seiko, you know, it takes them years to achieve this level of perfection, to achieve perfect flatness when you're polishing it up against a hard abrasive surface. If there's any unevenness to the case from the polishing, it's gonna warp. It's gonna create that distortion, which is not acceptable for Grand Seiko. No curvature, no blur, perfect. This is only attainable through Zeratsu.
レストランで食事をするということは、食べるものだけではなくて、その内装ですね、サービスの質ですとか、誰と行くとか、 どんな時間ですとか、それをすべて含めた経験をしていただいて、とにかく一個一個のことじゃなくて全体を考えてやっているので、そこでお客さんが嫌な思いをしたら、それをリカバーするのはものすごく大変なんですね。だから一個一個にこだわって、一個一個に、美味しいものを作っていくということをずっとやっているんですけど、わさびも魚によって変えているので、はっきりとは言えないんですけども、油の強いお魚にはわさびが効かないんですね。でイカみたいに、油が全くないものについてはわさびが効いてしまうんです。そこを加減をしながらやる、それはもう寿司屋の常識には近いところですけども、ここにこだわってやってる人っていうのは少ないので、違いが出るのはあるかもしれませんと。まあその時には失敗は許されないなと思いました。
Mechanical watches in their sweep display the moments between the seconds. Spring drive accounts for the moments between the moments. Spring drive was an idea, even if it was a far-fetched one. The concept for spring drive started in 1977. The engineer behind it was far ahead of his time, but after nearly 30 years of development, he was able to bring it to life. He wanted to take a watch that has a never-ending power source, that's powered by a mainspring, drives big heavy hands, has high torque, except it's doing it without collision, without friction, and it's doing it with the precision of quartz. This has created the culmination of both worlds of watchmaking, but also essentially created a mechanical watch that it can attain quartz precision all in one. Grand Seiko standard was made to exceed that of the best industry standard at the time, which was chronometer. So it was very important to make sure that Grand Seiko always had the pinnacle in accuracy. An average daily rate of -3 to +5 seconds a day, which is a very strict criteria. Without experience, without a good teacher, you know, this wouldn't exist today. The marriage of learning that skill set from generation to generation, that's the real tradition aspect of it. But today, manufacture parts much more precisely, much more durable, much more everything that you need for a watch. Everything can be made better today than it was in the past. And so you have tradition, but also coupled with modern manufacturing techniques that really create a distinct and different product. And they're subjected to these tests that are ridiculously difficult. There's an artistry to it.
メジナは白身なので、もともと香りを持っているわけではないんですよ。だけどそこに、桜の花の粉を、自家製ですよ、もちろん、つけることによって春の香りをつけると。どうぞ。そういうちっちゃなことの積み重ねで、お店の雰囲気っていうのも作れるので、すごく大事だと思います。
Take the SBGK005. The dial defines Mount Iwate. Look at the snowflake. The surface of the snow that's been swept by the wind. Through creating these ultra fine textures, what Grand Seiko has become renowned for, you can express so much. These details are subtle.But if you see them, if you take the time to understand them, they're moving.
やっぱり職人とはっていうのは、1秒1秒一手ごとですね、それごとによくしようという意識を持って仕事をしている人のことを言うんじゃないでしょうか。それで自分がそういうふうに呼ばれた時っていうのはすごく嬉しかったし、やっぱりでも嬉しかっただけにプレッシャーが大きかったです。
Do you make great sushi?
まだ途中ですかね。
This has been a 60-year journey to perfection. When you take pride in something, you commit yourself to it fully. It takes patience, respect. Anything less would be an injustice to the wearer, the watch itself, and its creator.